In today's video, we have a head-to-head competition between the Ortur Laser Master 2 Pro and the Atomstack M4. Hey everyone, my name is Sam, and welcome back to Samcraft. That is right, today's video is a head-to-head competition between the two lasers to see which one can engrave slate faster, which one gives better quality, and ultimately, if you're looking to buy this machine or that, which one may be a winner for you. If you follow my channel for any length of time, you'll have seen that I've done several videos on slate engravings, and slate coasters is by far my number one product that I sell. Historically, I've always used my Ortur Laser Master 2 Pro 10 watt diode for all of my slate engravings, and I have grid board set up so I can put 9 on there at once, set it, and forget it. Ever since getting my Atomstack M4 laser and seeing how much faster the galvo laser is compared to the traditional gantry diode laser, I've always wondered, could I change the processes to do my work on the Atomstack, save myself more time overall, or is it just better to let the Ortur sit, cook a while, and engrave them on its own? And so that begs the question, okay, which one is faster? Because honestly, it's going to come down to speed and time investment. So today's video is going to answer that question. Between the Ortur Laser Master 2 Pro and the Atomstack M4, which one will engrave these slate coasters the fastest and the best? All right, guys, got you set up here at Laser Town. I am doing a screen recording so you can see what's up there, but also pointing this to me so you can hear me and see me when I say something important. What I'm going to do first is load up the CCAD program here for the Atomstack M4, and I'm going to go ahead and bring in my Samcraft logo, make my maximum dimension 70 millimeters, not because that's the size I want per se, but that's the maximum the Atomstack M4 is going to do. All right, let's go ahead and launch CCAD here, and let's import our vector. For this, I'm going to be using the Samcraft brand. It's the simple, most basic thing I can do. Pretty applicable. It seems like it's what I always engrave on stuff here on this channel, but it's also beneficial for, I don't know, giving away coasters or whatever I do with these that I'm about to make. Okay, we have our logo imported here. I'm gonna go ahead and resize it, make it 70 millimeters, enter, application, click to recenter, and zoom in on this thing here. Let's go ahead and fill in this shape here. Now, the one thing that's kind of weird with the DXF file for my logo, I'm only able to fill it in by doing the like circle from outside in. That's why you see me do it every time with this Atomstack. For whatever reason, I've not figured out why it won't do the crops back and forth infill. Like this one, if I have it selected here and I click OK, it always fills in the middle of the A's. I'm assuming it's something with my DXF file. I don't know what. I've tried this for a while to fix it. I can't figure it out. So we'll just move ahead. We'll do this one as concentric fill, and the Ortur is going to get more of a linear fill. So that's how that's going to work. All right, so my setup is done here in CCAD. Let me hop over to Lightburn. And we'll load in the same logo here. And let's go ahead and center it here on my template, right in the middle of the wasteboard. Perfect. To make this as close as possible to an apples-to-apples comparison, I want to make sure my line interval and lines per inch are at least similar. So let's go back over here. I have line interval 0.05, so we'll change that. So we'll say okay to this for the Ortur. Go back to the Atomstack. This is ready to go. Going back to my initial test piece here I did when I got the laser, I'm gonna set my speed to 250 millimeters per second, and my power will be 100%. For the Ortur, the best settings I get are 6,000 millimeters, 85% power, so that will work for the Ortur. Now the next thing for me to do is put some blanks here on the lasers, set them up, and then press go. All right, we put our coaster here, adjust our focus. Looks pretty good. Now let's go ahead and do F1 to outline. Yeah, looks pretty good too. So we'll go ahead and escape to stop that. And so that is all set up. Now we'll set up the Ortur. We'll do the same thing here, put the coaster in place, focus. I'll have to rehome after this, I know, but this is easier. Both lasers are set up, ready to go. I want you to go ahead and stop here, Write me a comment down below. Which one is going to be faster, Atomstack or Ortur? Single coaster. I think we'd all know the answer on this one. Maybe. We're going to test a single first, and then we're going to test a four-pack, knowing that I can load all four at once versus doing one at a time. Which one's really faster? All right. Let me get my phone out, get my stopwatch ready to go. We're going to start off with the Ortur in the corner, and then we'll do the Atomstack. All right, everything's ready. I have my safety glasses on. Going ahead and clicking start on the computer and tapping this button as simultaneously as I can. Let's go. Minutes 31 seconds. Okay, same situation here. F1 to outline looks good. We'll start this in 3, 2, 1, go. That was a lot faster than I thought. Okay, 29 seconds. I previously said that I was going to do a four-pack test. There's no point in that. The Atomstack did this in 29 seconds or less. I was a little bit late on hitting that button, while the Ortur did this in 3.5 minutes. The quality-wise of the engrave is identical. I don't see really any big differences between the two, but there is something interesting that is worth noting. If you look here at the Ortur's engraving, it is a little more yellow or brown, especially when you compare it to the Atomstack. That is a much more blue or gray looking engraving. I guess the different light wavelengths react differently with slate, but this is not a single anomaly. I noticed this whenever I did my tests with the initial review video on the Atomstack, and I've also noticed it doing a few other things as far as slate comparisons. Other materials, I'm not sure yet. I don't know if I like the slate on the Atomstack or the Ortur better. That color difference is very interesting. The Atomstack looks a lot cleaner, it being a lighter color, but from a distance, the Ortur stands out more. At least it does to me. What do you think? Do you like one color engraving over the other? Do you know why the Atomstack does it in blue while the Ortur does it in a more brownish hue color? If so, let me know down below. So obviously the Atomstack is the clear winner here on speed. What it can do in 30 seconds takes the Ortur 3.5 minutes to do. That being said, I don't know that I'm going to be using the Atomstack solely and just relegate the Ortur to, I don't know, background eye candy. Between the two, I like the color and finish that the blue light diode gives as opposed to the 1064 nanometer light on the Atomstack. It is a more natural warm tone, and it is something that, at least for me, is easier to see from a distance. I suppose this could be one of those examples where I'm going to choose quality over quantity. If you want to think of maximum output per hour, I'm going to pick the thing that gives me the finish that I can see and that I like, versus the one that can give me the finish the quickest that I can get. But that's just my opinion. What do you guys think? If you had this setup, you had these two lasers, you had a bunch of these to make, what would you yourself do? Which one do you like? Are you thinking that I'm insane for not liking this one? Let me know. That's what the comment section is all about. Otherwise, if you guys got any other questions or comments, things you'd like to see, any more head-to-head competition or tests, be sure and let me know. But as always, I appreciate you guys for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys next time in the workshop.